गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट मेंडल्स लॉज ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस। नो फ्रेंड्स, मेंडल्स लॉ इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट्स इन द जेनेटिक्स। यू नो दैट इट इज मोस्ट पॉपुलर एंड ऑल्सो एंड वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग ऑल्सो टू लर्न। सो व्हाट मेंडल्स, मेंडल वॉज द फर्स्ट हु गेव एन आइडिया अबाउट जीन द फैक्टर, व्हाट एट दैट टाइम वॉज कॉल्ड फैक्टर। सो एक्चुअली Mendel was a Gregorian man, Gregorian monk, Gregorian monk, who lifespan varies from 1820 to 1812. Is that right? So he is very interested in study of different varieties of characters that we can say. So while he joined as a monk in the Czechoslovak monastery of Brno, at Czechoslovakia, as a monk, he did his experiment. He conducted his experiment on garden pea plants to know the different characters and their inheritance properties. So finally his experiment came out to the light in 8 July 1865. He published his experiment conducted in the pea plant in 8 July 1665, but that experiment could not be get recognized because nobody paid interest to that study. So after 35 years, what happened? After a lapse of 35 years, that is in the year of 1900, three scientists separately conducted their experiment. They did their experiments and found the same result whatever got by the Mendel. So they are Hugo de Vries number one, two Carl Schuren, number three G. Texmark. So these three scientists, Hugo de Vries, Carl Schuren and G. Steinmark, they did their experiment and conducted their experiment and separately on the Mendel and found the same result. Since then it got popularized, then the Mendel study, Mendel's experiment, Mendel laws got quite recognized. So let us see. We are going to discuss about the Mendel's experiment. So as we have already discussed, the Mendel conducted two experiments on garden pea plants. One is called a monohybrid cross, another one is called dihybrid cross. So let us discuss about this, what is the monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. Mendel's monohybrid cross. In a Mendel's monohybrid cross, what did Mendel? Mendel selected two contrasting characters. The opposite characters are selected by Mendel. One is tall character and dwarf character. So he crossed this tall character and dwarf character and found that in the F1 generation, in the filial generation, the offsprings are of mixed gene. In the genotypically they are mixed, but phenotypically they are quite tall. So he found that the tall character he here dominates the recessive character, the dwarf character, suppress the rough character and express itself, which from which he derived his law of dominance, from this Mendel's what monohybrid class itself. So let us see. So Mendel took tall varieties of pea plants and dwarf variety. So we can write tall and crossed with this small t dwarf varieties. And what he did, he found in the F1 generation, this is called the F1 gen or filial generation. This is the parental generation. So see what happened when these F1 generation, the offsprings of this generation are self-crossed, then he found four varieties of plant in the ratio, phenotypic ratio, or phenotypically they are 3:1. That means we can say when this is crossed again, so what did he found? Let us see friends, there are four varieties of plants. Out of these, three are tall. It is your F2 generation, second filial generation, and he found the ratio, the phenotypic ratio here. Three is to one. That means three talls and one dwarf. This is called Mendel's phenotypic ratio of Mendel's monohybrid cross. But the genotypic ratio of Mendel's monohybrid cross was 1:2:1. That means pure dwarf and these two is mixed tall. Okay friends, this is called the genotypic ratio of Mendel's monohybrid cross, and this is the phenotypic ratio of Mendel's monohybrid cross. And you remember that 3:1, the phenotypic ratio is 3:1, whereas the genotypic ratio is 1:2:1. Okay, let us see the law of Mendel's second law of, or second experiment. In the Mendel's second Mendel's dihybrid cross, In Mendel's dihybrid cross, what did Mendel? Mendel selected four varieties of characters, means two pairs or four varieties of characters. In for his second experiment or Mendel's dihybrid cross, Mendel selected two pairs or four varieties of characters, and these were round, wrinkled, yellow and green. He took round with yellow and wrinkled with green. These are the nothing but the pod shaped and pod colors. Round wrinkles are the pod shapes, and wet, these are the pod shape and color. Okay friends, so how the experiment is conducted. Round wrinkle, round yellow, green, wrinkled green. That means you can say R R Y Y R R Y Y. when cross is made, he found RY. So this is the first filial generation. This is the parental generation. So this is the Mendel's second or dihybrid cross. Is it right? When this is self-crossed. When Mendel self-crossed these varieties of what? F1 generation, then he found the phenotypes, different variety of phenotypes, you can say. The different phenotypic ratio. Nine is to three is to three is to one. This is the phenotype ratio Mendel got from his what dihybrid cross. Let us see what is the genotypic ratio of Mendel's dihybrid cross. Okay. Let us see the Mendel's F2 generation. He self crossed the combinants which he got from his F1 first filial generation. Let us see what we are getting here. So R R Y Y. Here we are getting what? R R Y Y. Here we are getting R. Here we are getting R R Y. See, next we are getting here R Y. Here we are getting R R Y Y. Here we are getting here we are getting R R Y Y and R R Y Y. So these are the pure variety. So from this experiment, what Mendel got? So out of the 16, out of 16 characters, so Mendel got what? The phenotypic ratio. That is 9/16 is to 3/16 is to 3/16 to 1/16. Is it right? That means this variety of phenotype ratio we got, Mendel got from his dihybrid cross, or simply you can write 9:3:3:1 is the Mendel's phenotype ratio. This is the Mendel's phenotype ratio, and the let us see what is the genotype ratio. The genotype ratio is The genotype ratio is 1:2:1, 1:2:1, 2:4:2, 1:4:2, 1:4:2, 1:2:1:2:1. So friends, 1:2:2:1, 2:4:2:2, and 1:2:2:1. This is the what Mendel's genotype ratio of dihybrid cross. Now let us move towards Mendel's laws of experiment which are derived from the Mendel's both monohybridic and dihybrid experiments. So as we know that there are three laws derived from this. One is law of dominance, next is law of segregation, and the third one is law of independent assessment. The first two laws, law of dominance and law of segregation, are derived from Mendel's monohybrid experiment, while the law of independent assessment is derived from Mendel's dihybrid experiments. Let us discuss one by one. Mendel's laws of inheritance number 1 law of dominance law of segregation law of independent assessment the law of independent assessment these two laws the first two laws are derived from monohybrid cross and the last one is derived from Mendel's dihybrid cross okay this is law of dominance law of segregation is derived from the Mendel's monohybrid cross and the last one the law of independent assessment is derived from Mendel's dihybrid cross let us discuss the law of dominance Law of dominance. Mendel's this law is as we have already discussed. This law is derived from Mendel's monohybrid cross, from Mendel's monohybrid cross. Mendel's monohybrid cross. So in this experiment, what he found that the law state that. Mendel's law state this this law state when a pair of characters are consonant and crossed and he found that in the F1 generation one character is dominated by means one character dominates the other means the FUT one character is expressed though in case of C in case of Mendel's monohybrid cross we found there are two pair of contrasting characters were there but in the F1 generation what we got the tall character here instead of dwarf or mixed tall because you see here one character here the T tall character dominates tall character dominates this dwarf characters so T is expressed the tall character is expressed and the small T is a dwarf character is suppressed this is called Mendel's law of dominance when a pair of contrasting characters are what crossed in the F1 generation in the next generation it is found that though they genotypically they are mixed but one character is expressed other is suppressed the character which it is itself expressed is called dominant character here the T and the character which is suppressed is called recessive character recessive character and that is called T so these are the what Mendel's laws of inheritance from the what we got from the first law means when a pair of contrasting character mixed together one is expressed another is suppressed the character which is expressed is called dominant character and the character which is repressed is called the recessive character so this is the all about the Mendel's laws of what dominance now let us move to the second law law of segregation this law also derived from the Mendel's what monohybrid cross and this is called also law of purity gametes this is called the law of purity of gamete the law of purity of gametes. So see, the law state is that though characters, the genes for the characters which are mixed together, they do not get blend with each other. Instead, they get separate when they get during the gamete formation. Again speaking, the loss, according to this law, the genotype, the genes which are mixed for a particular characters, they do not get mixed, but instead they get separate out during the process of formation of gamete, during the time of gamete formation. So we can say, in this case, this was the Mendel's monohybrid class. The F1 generation, we got this type of character, but this was phenotypically, this is a tall, but genotypically, this was tall and deep. Those are the two constructing characters are present, but the phenotypically it is tall. But what during the gamete formation in the F2 generation, they get separated from each other, means the purity of gametes, because the gametes are not mixed. Instead, they are in their pure form. That means tall and dwarf, tall and dwarf. This is called Mendel's law of segregation. Okay, friends. This is also purity of gamete, because gametes are always pure. So this is called, this is Mendel's F2 generation. F2 generation, we find that this F1 generation splitted into tall and dwarf respect independently, or means they are segregated out, they do not get mixed with each other. Okay, this is law of segregation. Let us move to law of independent assessment. This is from Mendel's dihybrid cross. According to this law of independent assessment, state that when a cross is made between two individuals, when a cross is made between two individuals having different characters, suppose round yellow, wrinkled green, it is four type of characters are here present, round, yellow and wrinkled green. What he found, that these characters rearranged when they get chance in the next generation. They do not get blend, they do not get, get mixed, means when in the F1 generation, what we are getting here, YRYRY, but this is the F1 generation. But in F2 generation, what we are finding, in the next generation, F2 generation, they get segregated out, they get separated out, when they get sent, they are, what, they get reassorted, rearranged again when they get chance. So they do not get blend together. That means this is called the Mendel's dihybrid cross, Mendel's law of independent assessment, which is derived from Mendel's dihybrid cross. This is all about today's class. Thanks.